Good morning, everyone, and thank you for joining me today. Now, something interesting that I found in my reading, Living Theater by Edwin Wilson and Alvin Goldfarb, was that kabuki theater was a hallmark in the history of cosmetics. Now, I know that it's kind of an interesting offshoot off of theater, but the history of cosmetics has brought so much to the idea of gender roles and how females fit in to our social status that I just found it to be such an interesting point, especially because in most Japanese theater, the men played all the roles. Now, in kabuki theater, cosmetic design was very important. It distinguished characters from class and by identity, and gave birth to this idea that the paler the skin, the more beautiful one was. Now, this kabuki makeup eventually melded into the geisha look, which was about being beautiful in Japan. And from this geisha idea, we go into the more modern Japanese woman who still wears makeup designed off of these original ideas, which involves having a pale, even complexion, bright lips, lined eyes, obviously very exaggerated eyes to make them look as big as possible, because these are things that the Japanese people have been trained equal beauty. Now, originally, the idea of creating a larger eye and a paler skin with a red lip equaled the idea of higher status in women, because the paler the skin, the closer to that creamy, pure look they were. And they wanted to have bigger eyes from the theatrical idea that it made expression easier from the stage. But in our modern day and society, it actually is a nod to the Caucasian race, and wanting to resemble more of that look. So I just found that it was very interesting that as history has progressed, we've seen such an importance and emphasis on makeup and how it originally evolved from theater. Thank you.